the law. Many things. I brought a lot of notes. I hope I don't have to stick to them, because I want to speak to each of you about what law is and what law ought to be and what law too often isn't. I have a little picture on my notes. It's from one of my websites. It's a young man, and he's going like this. And above him is a huge foot. So if you could imagine that for just a moment, because I want to talk to you about that foot. Sometimes a gracious foot, sometimes a foot we need, but it's a foot nonetheless, and it's always there. Some people speak of the unseen hand of God. In my little cartoon, it's the unseen foot ready to come down on me when I miss the mark. The law. Actually, the only way to really begin to talk about the law is to speak to you about what we call the etymology of a word. And that word is jurisprudence. Long before I went to law school, I was already 36 or 37 years old. I had a friend who was a lawyer, and he inspired me. I thought, oh my goodness, if Jim can be a lawyer, well, certainly I can too. But we were actually at a gas station one time, and we were pumping gas into his little car, and this word came to me out of nowhere. Jurisprudence. I don't think I'd ever read it. I was a navigator, a radio operator. I did a lot of things before I went to law school, but surely had never seen that word before. But there was something about him or his presence, or maybe it was just God. And he said, jurisprudence. And I never forgot it. It became a keystone in my life. Later, in law school, in my third year, I was asked to write a paper. So I wrote a paper about jurisprudence, the etymology of jurisprudence. So actually, if you'll bear with me just a moment, and I will try not to refer to my notes too much, but I want to tell you that words are really, in some ways, all there is. This that we see is just, as some people call, Maya. It's just a moment in time. But in reality, God created everything by the Word. The Word that was made flesh and dwelt among us. Words are so important. Words are essential to us lawyers when we're plying our trade, because it's all about words. And this particular word really needs to be examined by all of us and needs to be taught in our schools, because there's a lot we can learn from this word, jurisprudence. It's one word, but it's more than a whole bunch of words stuck together. It's not even two words stuck together. It's actually, there's the prudence part has two words in it. Okay. Juris comes from the Latin noun jus, J-U-S, the first three letters of the word justice. But it has a meaning. It means right. It doesn't mean right like we have rights. It means right. What's good, what's proper, what is truly in God's will for each of us in our own way. Jus. A Latin word, well understood by Cicero in his courts of way back when, in Rome. Right. There's a Sanskrit equivalent. I don't want to get too boring, but just for fun, we'll go down this road just briefly. The word is yo. Y-O-H means what's right. In Hebrew, we have Yod, which is actually, if some of you may know that God's name is sometimes spelled in Hebrew with Hebrew letters, four Hebrew letters, sometimes called the Tetragrammaton. I don't want to get into all these technicalities, but nonetheless, the way we read from left to right, the Yod is the last letter. But in fact, it's read from right to left, and Yod is the first letter. And it means source of light, or light itself. Same word, just, yo, yod. What's right, what's true, what's always, what's important, what's good, what's God's will, what's God's kingdom. All of that in that little Latin word. Some languages equate just to stretching a thing straight. I found this was very interesting when I was studying for my paper in law school. But it also sometimes means taking that thing that's straight and bending it perfectly into a square corner, like the intersection of the cross. Perfectly straight. Perfectly perfect. Perfectly just. Jurisprudence is not just another word for law. Today, unfortunately, we have legal education failing in this country. I can say that on the official opinion of the dean of the law school of our University of Florida, who actually said that at a meeting recently of the Martin County Bar Association. Legal education is failing. I believe that you will agree with me that if it's failing, it's failing because we have left something out. And I hope by the time I finish today, which I hope will not be too long, that what is being left out is the just part and the prudent part of that word that we now misuse. We talk about medical jurisprudence, commercial jurisprudence, criminal jurisprudence, as if it's just another word for that particular aspect of the law as man makes it. But that's not what it is at all. Just is law God made. Now there's another word for law in the Latin, and in the German, and in the French. In the Latin it's lex. Lex is the law that man makes. Lex is the law that says how fast you're allowed to drive out here on East Ocean. Lex is the law that says that you really shouldn't park where there's blue lines. And there really is somewhere, maybe in Tallahassee, maybe in my friend Ed Gallant's office, somewhere is written down that very law. That lex that men make. But it's not the just that God is. You see, God is just. In the French, what's right is, and I may pronounce this wrong, forgive me, I never took French classes, droit. But their written law is loi. Not much difference. D-R-O-I-T, or could be D-R-O-I-T-E, that's what's right. But what their written law is L-O-I. Droit and loi. Two different things. The German says what's right is Recht. His code of rules is Gesetz. Two different things. We don't think about that much in our society. We just think, well, the law is what it is. And when we hear the word law, we think either God's law, the Ten Commandments, or the law that Brother Cederberg just read to you? Or that speed limit on East Ocean? We have not been educated in the law in this country. And sadly, those who are going to our law schools today are not being much educated in the just part of jurisprudence. Now we'll go quickly to the second part of that word, prudence. Comes from the word prudens, which in Latin is practical understanding or sagacity, wisdom, foresight, common sense. Comes from two words, pro and videns. Pro, of course, means forward, and videns, like where we get the word video, is seeing, foreseeing. Now think about that for a moment. Right, seeing forward, looking at the present, seeing the need, and then looking forward. Not just looking at the present, not just dealing with the exigent circumstances of the moment, as too many of us are allowing others to do to our social and national detriment. Exigence is a very strong pressure. Exigence fell upon us September the 11th. I was in the United States Attorney's Office in Orlando, the head man. We were called from his office. I went out. I couldn't believe it. There it was, the airplane going into the building. And exigence put itself upon us, and we decided we must do something. And maybe not all that we did or are doing or may continue to do if we do nothing here. Maybe we didn't look forward. Maybe we didn't use jurisprudence, the right looking forward to see what is the consequence. Is that Bigfoot up there? Or are we fools to believe there is no Bigfoot? God has a Bigfoot. I've felt it from time to time. I think maybe some of you in here have from time to time felt God's Bigfoot, if you will admit it. Maybe you don't have to admit it to others, but I see some of you are smiling, and thank you for that. There's a consequence. So, good law is what that word used to mean. It's law that looks forward. It's lex that seeks to be just. We will have to struggle to make lex be just. And we will have to be wise to look forward and consider the consequence if we do not look forward. Because there's always a consequence. Jurisprudence today is just another word for law. And there are children weeping in the darkness. And it ought not be so.